In the previous video, I showed how to integrate a web app with a user's Slack workspace. As a result of integration, we receive an access token. Using this token, we can call Slack API methods to obtain information and perform actions in user's workspace. In this video, I will show you a case of creating new conversation, adding members to it, and sending messages. Let's see what we have after I integrated my web app with my Slack workspace that I did in the previous video. Brain Assistant custom app installed in my Slack apps. In the database, I have the document with access token, auth user ID, and Slack bot user ID. Now use this all to a new feature for my web app. Every time I create a new task, I receive a Slack message in the Brain Assistant channel. This doesn't really have much practical value, so you can treat this as a teaching example. We can leave the front-end code out of consideration, since interaction with the Slack API occurs on the backend. The crucial logic associated with the Slack API is housed in the Slack service class. I'm running the message sending logic here in the create new task use case class. We need to pass two parameters to the send message method: the message itself and the ID of the user who should receive this message. Let's see what happens in the send method. First, I need to initialize my web client, which I will use to interact with the Slack API. I do this in separate private method init web client. I am getting a user's access token from a database. In the previous video web app integration with Slack, I explained how to obtain it from the Slack OAuth API. So in this video, we have it in the database already. This is what it looks like in my MongoDB. I'll need these two parameters, the access token itself and the auth user ID. Auth user ID is set to the private property of the service class. This is the ID of the user who has allowed access to their workspace, and we will need it a little later. The web client class is part of the Slack Web API library. The Slack Web API npm package is a project dependency. I pass the access token to the web client for initialization and send the instance object as a private property of the service. Now we can use it to interact with the API. I want to post a message in the channel associated with the app, so we need to make sure the channel exists. And I do this in the private service method, create channel if not exist. Here are three Slack conversation API methods involved: list, create, and join. First, I call the conversations list method. It returns all channels in a Slack team. I iterate through all the channels in the list to find the one whose name is given in channel name constant. In my case, Brain is up. If the channel is not found, I create it using the conversations create API method with the channel name as a parameter. If the channel exists, I need to check if the app bot user is a member of the channel, just in case, because it is possible that the user has previously created a channel with the same name, in which case the application bot will not be a participant. To check this, I use the isMember property of the channel interface. If the Slack bot is not a member, we need to use the conversationsJoin method to become a member. Let's take a look at what a Slack bot user is. Here is a picture of basic idea behind integrating a web app with Slack. We built our own Slack app using the Slack API platform, and a user installed it with some permissions that app requested. So the web app can interact with the user's workspace through this application using the Slack Web API. Technically, the installed app acts like a real user, can create channels, invite members, and post messages, which is why we call it the Slack apps bot user. For example, if we print out the channel object, we can find in the creator field the Slack bot user ID, which we store in the database with an access token, since this bot user is a real actor in the user's workspace. Once the channel is created and we have its ID, we need to add the user who has allowed access to his workspace to this channel. I do this in the private method addUserIfNotInChannel, where I use two conversation API methods, members and invite. I'm using conversations members to get all channel members and check if the user is there. The auth user ID, which I got early from the database with the access token. If the user is not found in the list of members, we need to add him to the channel using the conversation invite API method. So when a channel exists and the user is a member, we can post a message using the chat post message API method. In this video, I showed the example of using the Slack Web API to create channels, invite members, and send messages. To do all of this, you need to have an access token. And in my previous video, I showed how to obtain it. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget about LSBC button. Like, subscribe, bell, comments.